Young dad struck a match and the match went out. But it wasn't no more lights in the house. Check it out. Speaking of hoppers, play your game, mother. Are you with it? I go get it, I bet you love it, baby. I play the daddy and you can play the mama, so we can get down upon the living room floor. Are you with it?
Guys, what is up? Welcome to another episode of Maximilian Must Know. We've got one for you today that, when this came out, was a real hype beast and got a lot of comparisons to a big-time vanilla scent by Guerlain called Spiritus Double Vanille. Well, folks, from the house that is called Le Couvent de Mon Ami, the fragrance we're going to be looking at today is called Eau de Michon. And before we make the comparisons and get into this one, let's briefly talk about this house. So really, the history of this house goes back to more than 500 years ago, when a convent was built in Maine, in the south of France, for the botanist monks of the Order of Mon Ami. And this line is totally inspired by the plant-based recipes that were developed back then at this convent. And of course, there's a modern spin placed on all of the recipes. This brand was created not 500 years ago, but in 2004, and it is a side venture by L'Occitane. I'm sure many of you guys know L'Occitane, the French skincare company that started off in Provence with lavender products. But they also have some L'Occitane, some very popular fragrances as well, Eau de Bao, Eau de Cade, in the men's online fragrance community, probably being the most too popular. But they do a lot, and so does Le Couvent de Mon Ami. They do a lot of different skincare products, from foot creams to soaps and deodorants to serums, and of course, fragrances. As of me filming this, they have about 5 different fragrances. This one was first on my list because I got a sample from Decant Shop and was so impressed by it. And so it was the first that I've purchased. And as of right now, there is only one more that I plan on purchasing from the brand, and that is their Cologne de Matin, or Morning Cologne. And that one sounds really interesting to me. It has notes of apple, orange, lemon, basil, and cedar. Sounds up my alley. But as of today, guys, as I said, this is the only one that I own from the house. Now, this one comes in two sizes. You can get the 3.4 ounce bottle, which you see in front of you, for $38, or you can get an 8.4 ounce bottle for $49. You can also get a bar of soap if you like this fragrance for $7, and it is all available on the company's website. That is where I bought my 100 ml bottle for $38. The notes on this one are vanilla, myrrh, benzoin, camellia, and Virginia cedar. Now, I don't want to dig the box up, I'm not going to lie to you, for the presentation. Also because it looks a lot like the bottle, but let's take a look. Eau de Michon Cologne, Botanical Cologne of the Missions. You have like a photo or a drawing of the, obviously it's a drawing of the convent. You have the name, you have the notes, as you could see at the bottom, Le Couvent de Mon Ami, Maine. It says 3.4 ounces. What I don't like is that it really is like a cheap plastic atomizer that just screws on and off. It's hard to kill it, I know, but the cap is really cheap in plastic. I just think they could have done a little bit better of a job with that, like L'Occitane does. But overall, it doesn't look that bad, the whole package. I just don't like the screw-on top personally. I love the font and the whole aesthetic of the sticker, which looks like something sort of vintage that you might find in an apothecary. So let's start by saying that Spiritus Double Vanille, for me, is not the holy grail vanilla fragrance. There's one that I like much better. It's not totally vanilla, but like my favorite vanilla-centric fragrance is by Lubon, and it's called Corrigan. And you guys know I've reviewed that one. It's this really nice vanilla scent with cognac notes. There's ambrette in it. It's spicy, it's boozy, but it's different than Spiritus Double Vanille. Spiritus Double Vanille can remind me a little bit of vanilla extract. And Corrigan is just more out there. The ambrette seed sort of makes it a more complete fragrance to me. Another fragrance that I like better as well is called, I think it's called, it's not Vanille Absolument. Oh yeah, actually it is. I like Vanille Absolument better by L'Artisan Parfumé, and that's by Bertrand Duchaufour, and that sort of has a fragrance that I'm going to review it down the line. It used to be called Havane Vanille for L'Artisan Parfumé, and that one sort of is like vanilla bean pod soaking in rum. So I like that one, and there's another one from a lesser known fragrance house that I'll review down the line, an indie house that I think is a better vanilla fragrance. So I would not pay Guerlain money for Spiritus Doublé Vanille, but because I appreciate it, I did want something in my collection reminiscent of Spiritus Doublé Vanille, and that's almost exactly how I feel about Tobacco Vanille. I didn't want Tobacco Vanille in my collection because I know a lot of people that wore it, so I got Tobacco 1812 by West Third Brand. And this is sort of the same thing. This is my alternative. And I will tell you, this for me, out of the bottle, this is a watered-down version of Spiritus Doublé Vanille. It smells similar, but it doesn't have the punch of the performance. And what this smells like is this boozy and resinous vanilla fragrance. It's not that complicated, and it's not hard to explain. And both Spiritus and this have some depth to them, but this one is way more shallow. It's almost like if you made Spiritus to the formula with cheaper materials, and then you cut the concentration by like 75%. That's my best explanation of this fragrance. And again, as far as description of this one goes, just really think vanilla beans soaking in booze with some faint incense burning in the background. That incense becomes a little more prominent as the scent evolves on the skin, and the booze becomes a little less prominent. For me on this one, performance is okay. It is not great, and it definitely does pale in comparison to Spiritus Doublé Vanille. To me, this is a 5-hour scent with soft projection, not great sillage. It's certainly a unisex fragrance. I think it's really appropriate for all times of year, but even with the lightness, it's still probably a little inappropriate for really hot summer days. And for me, I would use this as a night out or date night fragrance personally. If you're unable to get this, or you do want the better version of this, well, go get yourself Spiritus Doublé Vanille by Guerlain. Check out a fragrance called Estate Vanilla by Solstice Scents. Excellent vanilla boozy fragrance. Again, you guys know I think Corrigan is better. And I think I also like Vanilla Flash by Andy Towerville better. And that's a $63 fragrance. If someone were trying to talk you into purchasing this one, I think they would tell you that great price. If you don't want Spiritus Doublé Vanille, check this one out. And even if you do want that one, at least check this one out. I think on the flip side, it's not Spiritus Doublé Vanille, and the bottle isn't all that great. Spiritus Doublé Vanille has a gorgeous bottle. All the Guerlain Art and Materials fragrances do, although there was an original Spiritus bottle that some people like it because it's the older bottle. I like the newer one better with the gold on the side, personally, myself. So what am I going to rate this one? Pretty easy for me. This is a 5 out of 10. It's not original, it's not a great performer, and it's not a great bottle. But it's a good fill-in and stand-in for someone who just can't part with $260 or whatever it is that Spiritus Doublé Vanille costs. If you can't get that and you want that, I'd look at this. But I'd also look at Estate Vanille and see if that floats your boat. That's a $70 fragrance, you know? You don't have to spend $250 to get a great vanilla fragrance. That's my opinion. I'm sure there's some people out there that disagree. You know, I like Memoirs of a Trespasser by Imaginary Authors better than Spiritus, but again, that's me. Some people love Spiritus, and I understand why they do, and I'm not saying they're wrong. It's just obviously, you know, my opinion on it. So guys, if you have any questions about this one, I'd be more than happy to try to answer them for you. Any questions at all you want to ask or whatever, you know, you can always get me at maxmno@gmail.com or just leave a comment. And I'll see you guys next week with more videos. You know what it is, guys. My name is Max and Money.
I'm sticking in my background, picking up a hole for you to make your move.